Now we're going to get into the archaic traditions. Now, over the years, the archaic generation, those that lived anywhere from 30,000 years ago to about 5,000 years ago, they were in constant motion. They were in constant movement. And the people's botanical knowledge allowed them to either search for and or locate, inventory, and use every existing food resource that the earth has to offer. Now, depending on the environmental topography, the peoples are going to travel and take advantage of what was in season. Art forms indicate that they were in relationship with the plants and animals. People became familiar with over 200 medicinal herbs on this continent alone. Today, it is understood amongst native religious elders that there are 405 sacred herbs. And perhaps you have some of those herbs in your kitchen today. There is spearmint or yerbabuena, there is chamomile or manzanilla, there is goose foot or the amaranth. Now, what the archaic generation left Americans is a moving, venturing spirit. They tried all environments. Don't you, as an American, like getting into your automobile and traveling throughout this North American continent? Only the archaic peoples, they didn't have automobiles, they had patamobiles. People created settled communities in all environments, from the woodlands of the east with abundant streams and long shorelines to the deserts and the plains, where the people by necessity followed seasonal cycles of harvesting foods complemented by small game hunting. So their movements were purposeful. Their movements were scheduled, and every ecological niche on this earth was occupied, and the botanical knowledge coupled with their spiritual relationships to the plants and animals led to some very sophisticated religious practices. Native peoples celebrated life through dances. Dances in native cultures reveal classification of human relationships to creation, to God, if you will, to a higher power. Native peoples dance to assert their connection to the environment, to assert their connection to the universe. But most importantly, they developed a tool that allowed them to move throughout the continent. And this is known in Nahuatl as the metate y mano, the mortar and the pestle that's used by pharmacists today, the molcajete that's found in every Mexican kitchen. It is what I call the first American Express card. You did not leave home without it. Now, the metate y mano allowed people to develop long-distance trading. Now, how do anthropologists know this? Well, olivella shells were carried from the coast of California to the woodlands of the Northeast. Copper was traded out of Lake Superior eastward and southward for hundreds of miles into Mexico. Rocky Mountain obsidian was made into projectile points in Illinois, Wisconsin, and the Midwest, and it was prized in Mexico. Shark and alligator teeth from the warm waters off of Florida, the Florida coastline, were valued as utilitarian art objects in the Ohio Valley. Today's modern freeway system is built on the pathways that were created by these peoples. And the metate en mano, the milling stone, allowed people to move throughout the continent to try all environments. So let's go to a film clip from a documentary entitled In Light of Reverence, and let's appreciate how the archaic traditions continue to the present day.